video, we'll go over troubleshooting and repairing the internet connection on a Verifone VX series device. We'll be starting from the default idle sales screen, and we're going to leave that screen and move to the applications screen by pressing the star key, and then we're going to go into comm server by selecting F2. On the screen, you will see it says VCS Ethernet. It has a black bar with a diamond moving through it. This indicates that there is a wire connected to the terminal and is connected to the router, and the terminal is seeing some amount of communication over that line. If this line was broken and or the diamond is open-faced, where it's got most of it missing, that would indicate that either the terminal is not getting a connection through the wire, so that could be the port in the terminal is bad, it could be the port on the router is bad, it could be the cable itself is bad, or it could just be that the cable is not plugged in on either end fully. So we're going to go back into comm server. This machine drops out of comm server if you don't stay in it for very long. If you do have that black bar, I would proceed to selecting the diamond icon, which is the far left purple button. And that'll pull up your current IP configuration. So this machine is set with a dynamic IP address, so it's using DHCP, and it's showing me the IP address information that it has obtained from our network. If you are set up with a static address, this will say static enabled, and it will also show you the information that you've previously put into the device. You'll want to check this and make sure it's within the scope of your network parameters. That might be something to address with your IT team or your internet service provider. If everything looks correct in this screen, you can go ahead and back out with the red X, and then you can select the tools icon, which is the purple button just to the right of the alpha key. We'll select that. It's going to give us three options. We have ping, troubleshoot, and repair. You could go through and ping each part of your network all the way out into the internet, one at a time, which would be fine. However, troubleshoot actually does that for you. So we'll go ahead and select F3 for troubleshoot, and it's going to go through a series of tests. And at the end, it's going to give us the option to print that series of tests. So I'll go ahead and print it now with the far right purple key below the word print. I'll tear that off and see if we can lay this down for you. You might be able to see it as well. Starting off with the ping gateway test, it has an address, but it is unable to get a response. This could indicate that the terminal is unable to talk to your router. However, some routers are designed or set up to not respond to these kind of requests, so that may not be terribly, you know, out of the ordinary. The next one is the DNS ping test, and clearly it has the same address as the gateway or the router, so it's looking back at that router to get its DNS information, and it received no response. Whatever response you get on the same address should probably remain the same. So that wouldn't be super concerning at this point. We move on to the DNS lookup, and here it's looking up verifone.com. It is receiving an IP address during its DNS lookup, and it communicated with that address in 51 milliseconds. So now this test would imply that it's actually communicated to the gateway, moved beyond the gateway to the grander internet. It received the information it needed to contact Verifone.com and received a response from Verifone.com. Post-ping is a very similar test. It's doing the DNS lookup, it's communicating with Verifone.com again, and again we're getting a 19-second response. So this would indicate we are getting fully to the internet and we are communicating. The next test is the Tcp Connect. This is where it's going to connect to an unsecured website or URL address and see if it can get a response from that. So in this case, the terminal opted to use yahoo.com on port 80, which is unsecured, and it did receive a connection. So again, this is very similar to the last two tests. We move into the Ssl Connect, where it's connecting to login.yahoo.com on port 443. So this is going to be a secured port, and clearly we've got some errors here. So this would be indicating that either something is set wrong in the terminal, or there's a configuration at the processor that is set wrong, so when the terminal tries to communicate through its secure port, it's not being allowed to. that would be an indication to contact the processor, explain to them what this report's saying, and see if, what they need to do to address that. If you are getting gateway ping responses and DNS ping responses and they're the same address, but you're not getting the DNS lookup or the host ping, that's likely going to be something within your network. So you're communicating to the devices on your network, but you don't seem to be getting out beyond your network. So if you're not getting the DNS lookup, that's not going to be able to take the domain name or the URL, convert that into an IP that the terminal can communicate with. That would be a time to check your DNS settings in the device, or if you're on DHCP, check the DNS settings on your router. If you are getting the DNS lookup, but you're unable to, say, ping the host verifone.com, for instance, that may be that Verifone's no longer responding to ping requests. So you may want to go in, do the ping manually to a couple of other sites, maybe that you've tried to ping from your computer, see what that response is. If you're still having issues there, that would be a good time to contact your ISP or whoever handles your local network there at the office. Once you've worked out and you've gotten all these tests going correctly, you can drop out of this comm server menu. That said, you may even want to try going back under tools and using the repair option. And basically, it's not going to do anything more than drop the IP address that was given to it through the dynamic system, through the DHCP server, and just request a new one. And so basically, it'll say successful. You can go in and do your troubleshoot test again, and then see if that's fixed any issues. Very similarly, you can just try a reboot and see if that maybe gets it to resync with your network. But again, if you're having a lot of issues with the connection side, that's going to be talking to your ISP or whoever handles your network. If you're getting SSL errors, that's where you're going to be looking to the processor to figure out what's causing that. And that could be an ISP issue, but generally not. That's going to be on the processor side. Once you're finished in the comm server menu, you can just red X back to the VCS Ethernet page, press the star key, and then select soft pay or credit debit or whatever your payment application is called. Mine is on the F3 button. It'll load that app, and then once you know you've got everything running with the IP and the comm server side, then it'll be a time to go in and do a test transaction. A lot of transactions will give you particular errors, and it's very important to note what that exact error is. A lot of times it'll have a number associated with that error, and that information can be very helpful to support at the processor if you do need to call them.